Today I would like to talk to you about presentations. With education and so many other pedagogies coming into the picture today, everybody wants to be updated with the latest in extending their knowledge or sharing knowledge. So I'd like to talk to you about how students can use presentations as an effective way to share their ideas. Now, students often go for industry work, for summer internships, or for any other project work. When they finished or done with their internships, these organizations expect the student to give a presentation on what they have learned during their internship. In another case, students may be working on projects in the classroom or during their coursework, and at the end of the semester, they are expected to give a presentation to say what they have learned, how they've been progressing with their projects. So today, I'd like to talk to you about what presentations are, and then I would like to move on to talking about PowerPoint presentations, which most students use these days. So what is a presentation? A presentation is sharing your ideas, views, after you've done some kind of research on a topic with an audience who is interested in knowing more about the topic that you're going to talk about. Now let's say I come and tell you that I'm going to talk to you about the sun. The audience is always waiting to know what I'm going to tell them about the sun, and in addition to this, what new I'm going to tell them. Now, let's first start with what the objectives of a presentation are. When I ask students, have you done a presentation? There is a yes and a no. All right. A presentation, as I said, is sharing your ideas, putting forth something through the use of body language, the use of subject matter, and certain other things. Now, a presentation, as I said, is sharing information to an audience. So, which means that there is a subject matter, there is an audience who is going to listen to you. Now, there are different types of presentations. The first presentation that you were exposed to is probably in school when you started reciting rhymes. You did twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are, up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Now that sounds a little funny at this stage, but still, that was probably the first presentation anybody ever did. So if I asked you, did you do a presentation before? You should be able to say yes. But right now, we are going to talk to you about presentations that you are going to use in the classroom or in the professional life. Now, talking about the types of presentations, I could possibly talk about an impromptu presentation or an extempore or an audition, a reading or reciting presentation, a lecture, and finally the most familiar PowerPoint presentations that we talk about today. What's an impromptu presentation? An impromptu presentation is one where you are given a topic and asked to speak on it immediately. You are not given time to prepare. Let's say you have your boss who has come down from the head office and he tells you, please tell me something about the project that you're working on. Please give me an update. Now you just need to quickly tell him what you've been doing. That's an impromptu presentation. What's an extempore? An extempore is an extension of an impromptu presentation. The only difference is here you're not given time, you're not given a topic, you're asked to speak spontaneously. In an extempore too, you're expected to speak spontaneously, but the advantage is that you're given a few minutes to prepare before you actually give your ideas or voice your views. We talk about auditions. Most of the TV channels have auditions for singing competitions, dance competitions, and so on. So that is also a kind of presentation. You're being able to showcase your talent, you're presenting your talent in terms of dance, in terms of song, or whatever it is. A reading or a recitation presentation, you have forums where people come to discuss about books that they have read. They read out excerpts from books to tell them what part of the book they liked and what was good about it or what could have been better, all right? Recitations, which again most students do in schools, recitation competition or at programs where you recite. So that's another kind of presentation that you do. Then you have lectures in the classroom where the teacher has to teach you something. So that's a kind of presentation that you have. And finally, our PowerPoint presentations. Now each of these presentations are used, either they overlap or they're used independently. All right? I will talk to you more about PowerPoint presentations in my next session. Now, before I move on to what PowerPoint presentations are, I'd like to talk to you about one important aspect about presentations. Now, when you do a presentation, as I already said, and I'm repeating again, you are going to talk to an audience about a particular aspect. You've done your research, you've done your reading, and you want to share this information. And when you want to share information, you're also opening the gateway to other people to give you their views. All right? So there's a kind of a discussion involved in a presentation. So the first thing that we talk about is a triangle between the subject matter, the visual aid, and the audience. These are the three elements that are most essential in a presentation. I'll talk to you in detail about what the subject matter is and how you go about preparing it, what I mean by visual aids, and the role of the audience in a PowerPoint presentation. I hope you will want to listen to more of this in my next episode. Thank you.